So you just picked up the Warhammer Underworlds Wyrdhollow box set. And you're wondering how to paint the peculiar Ephilim's Pandaemonium, ready for your first game. Well, don't worry, we're here to walk you through every step of the painting process, even if you've never picked up a paintbrush before. Painting is a fun and rewarding part of Warhammer, and by following this guide, you'll be able to get the entire warband painted, ready to play Warhammer Underworlds in no time at all. Before we start painting, you'll need to build your miniature. Have a look at our Painting Essentials Your Mini video for some top tips. You'll also need to gather some hobby items before you start. To paint miniatures, you'll need a water pot and some paper towel, and something to use as a palette. An old plate or even an old piece of cardboard will do the job. If you'd like to know more about setting up a painting area, we've got a handy video packed with helpful information. The paints we've used are listed on the screen now. We'll be showing you how to match the colours shown on the box art. In this case, it's the bright blues, pinks and green tones as each. However, it's entirely up to you how you paint your miniatures, so feel free to use your imagination. We've also included a list of brushes and mediums we've used, but feel free to use whichever brushes you feel most comfortable with, and you can replace mediums with water. The first thing we need to do is apply an undercoat to the miniature. This forms a foundation for the rest of your paints to stick to, and is an important first step in the painting process. You can apply an undercoat using a spray can or by applying multiple layers of paint from the pot. For this video, we've undercoated by spraying the model in Wraithbone. To learn how to do this, check out our video, Painting Essentials, Spray Paints and Undercoating. If you don't have the spray can, you can always paint multiple layers of Wraithbone from the pot. This will take longer, but is still an effective way of undercoating the miniature. It's also a great idea to have that pot of Wraithbone to hand, as we'll be needing it to tidy up any small smudges of unwanted colour on our model. So let's get painting! Our first paint we'll be using is Fenrisian Grey. Fenrisian Grey is a layer paint. These paints are thinner and lighter shades of paint than we normally use for layer and highlighting, but still great for the main colours on models. For Ephilim skin, it is the right shade and colour for this. Give the pot a good shake to mix up the colour. Then apply some to your palette, and then thin down with a drop of water. This makes it easier for each coat to be smoother when we apply it. And just make sure that every coat that we apply is dry before applying the next one. This avoids the paint pulling off from the last coat and making lumps in that paint job. Don't worry about being too messy at this stage, as we'll be using other colours later on to tidy up. You can use this colour as well on any of the skin or the rest of your warband. The choice is yours. Next, we'll be using Ahriman Blue. For this, we'll be using it on the cloth and the armour plates. You can also be messy with this colour, but be careful near the skin we just painted. This is also a layer paint, so thin it down slightly with a touch of water before using it. Just like we said before, you can always use layer paints just like base paints that we'll talk about next. You just need a couple of more layers to get a solid finish. You can also use this colour on the armour plates for Flame Spooler and Spawn More. Just check the book for any artwork for reference. Now we'll be using Incubi Darkness. This is a base paint, so it's slightly thicker than the layer paint we used before. These give a strong or dark base colour, perfect for making solid colours over undercoats. They can also be used for undercoating like we said at the beginning of this video. Remember to shake your pot of paint, thin it down with a touch of water on the palette, and apply just like we did before. We apply these paints by using base brushes, as they are the best size for these undercoats. We'll be applying Incubi Darkness onto the book, the base stone that they stand on, and the staff shaft as well. Just remember to keep each coat thin and let it dry before applying the next coat. With that base paint dry, next we'll be using Retributor Armor. This is a metallic paint. It's also a base paint as well, so we'll be thinning it down slightly with a touch of water on our palette. But you can see there are shiny small flakes. These build up a metallic sheen when you apply multiple coats. Now that's thinned down, we can apply it to the model. You can see there is quite a lot of gold detail on it, so just take your time and use a smaller brush. After a couple of thinner coats, you can see that it's a nice, smooth, shiny finish. Once we're finished with our gold details, we need to clean our paint water. This avoids us getting any metallic flakes into the rest of our colours, due to contamination of the water. Next, we'll be using Corandras Green. This is a contrast paint. They are thin but very strong pigmented colours. They create shading, colour and highlights. They work great for many things, from simple base colours to washes and effects. When straight out of the pot, it gives you that full effect of the colour, giving you that shading and highlighting at the same time. But once you've thinned it down and made it more translucent, it's perfect for some eerie warp magic effects. For the quill, we've used it straight out the pot. And for the warp magic, we have thinned it down with one part Corandras Green to three parts medium or water if you prefer. You can also use this for the magical flame on Kindlefinger and Spawnmore, and the feathers on a Potrax. Next, we'll be using Volupus Pink, which is another contrast. We'll be using this for the staff head, the tentacles on the base, and in that little book. And you can also use this for the body colours of a Potrax and Kindlefinger. Just like last time, you can either thin this down or use it straight out the pot. For this, we'll be using it just straight out the pot. To kind of break up that blue colour, we like to use a pink, as it gives a great balance to the model, but still works for the Tzeentchian colours of their magic. Just be careful how much contrast you apply, as it's quite thin and can run into other colours. If it does so, just take a dry brush and soak it away. Then you can apply the previous colours if you need to tidy up. When that contrast is dry, we'll move on to a shabby bone. We'll be using this for the teeth and the bookmark. Just give it a good shake and thin down on your palette, then we can apply multiple coats to get a smooth bone colour. And you can use this colour on all of the models in your warband. Next, we'll move on to Phalanx Yellow. And for this, we'll be using it on the eyes of all the models. This is a bright yellow which is going to stand out from all these blue tones. As these are very small details, we'll be needing our small layer brush for these. And you'll need to make sure that your brush keeps its point. You can do this by rolling your brush onto the palette. This also controls how much paint you have on your brush as well. Then you'll be ready to paint those eyes. Now we'll be moving on to some shading. Shade paints are very similar to contrast, but are lighter in colour and they settle into the recesses of the models. You can use it straight out of the pot, or thin it down with some Larmium medium or water. We'll use it straight out of the pot for that blue cloth and armour, and we'll thin it down for the skin and the white cloth. When our first shade is dry, we'll move on to Agrax Earthshade. And for this, we'll be using it on the gold, the teeth, and the eyes. This is quite a dark shade, so you may find that you want to thin it down so it's not too dark and strong. This shade works for many different reasons. It helps with gold tones in the metal and for that white creamy colour in the bone. But it also works great for darkening down other colours, such as the Incubi Darkness on the base. Now that our miniature is painted, we'll finish it off by painting the rim of the base. For this, we'll be using Abaddon Black and a small base brush. Just like before, we need to thin our base paint. Then we need to gently hold our miniature, and then we can go around the rim of the base. We'll need a few thin coats so we get a solid dark colour. Just be careful not to get any paint on the model, and also not to grip your model too hard. We don't want to break them. And there we are, Ephilim the Unknowable is painted and looking fantastic. You'll be able to get the whole warband painted quickly and easily, ready to unleash their unpredictable magics on the hexes of the Warhammer Underworlds board. For more tutorials, tips and techniques, head to citadelcolour.com or head into your local Warhammer store where our friendly staff will help you out. Well, we hope you enjoyed this video and we'll see you next time. Bye bye!